Within abiotic boundary conditions, ecosystems are formed and maintained by biota, the living organisms. Every ecosystem is unique, as it contains its own specific combination of plants, animals, and microorganisms that interact with each other. Ecosystems form and evolve through succession. Succession refers to the sequence of, mostly, plant species that succeed each other as the ecosystem matures in situations where external conditions stay more or less the same. Ecological succession is started by pioneer species. These are species that are the first to colonize an area. Pioneer species generally are specialists that can survive harsh conditions. The grasses that colonize beach areas to set of dune formation are good examples of pioneer species. Terrestrial pioneer plant species often are annual species. They ameliorate the environment so that other species that are secondary in succession can start establishing themselves too. These secondary succession species are often perennial plants, such as herbs and small woody plants. They are followed by shrubs, and the final stage of succession often contains trees. The final stage of succession is generally called the climax stage. Animals depend on plants for food and habitat. Therefore, also animal species composition often changes with the succession process. Often, succession can be visible as zonation in ecosystems. We speak of succession zonation when the different stages of succession can be seen in spatially separated zones. For instance, succession zonation often occurs within temperate salt marshes, from the intertidal flat towards the land. The closest zone to the intertidal flat is called the pioneer zone and is inhabited by pioneer species, such as English cordgrass and glasswort. Next to the pioneer zone comes the lower marsh zone, which is inhabited by secondary succession species. This is followed by a very diverse middle marsh, which contains a lot of different species and colorful flowers. Most land inwards, we find the high marsh, which is often dominated by grass species that form a rather homogeneous vegetation cover. This zone is only submerged a couple of times per year by really high tides. In the end, the high marsh will naturally develop into land with herbaceous forest on it. Here, a different ecosystem develops as it is no longer occasionally submerged under seawater. Zonation also often is visible on sandy and rocky shores where submersion time, salinity and temperature determine which plant and animal species are able to survive in that area. An example is the barnacle, that is able to withstand hours of exposure to air and heat at low tide, whereas other animals, such as sponges, need constant submersion. Ecosystems are not only formed, but also maintained by biota. Species that play a large role in the functioning of the ecosystem are called the keystone species. The keystone species are crucial for ecosystem functioning. Their effect on the ecosystem is often larger than one would expect based upon their abundance. The term originates from architecture. In big arch constructions, there is a single stone in the middle that holds together the entire arch. If this stone is removed, the arch collapses. Similarly, if keystone species are removed from an ecosystem due to, for example, a disease or overfishing, the ecosystem collapses and shifts towards a different type of ecosystem. Keystone species can fulfill a crucial role in the food web. They can be small predators or herbivores that prevent fast-growing species to overwhelm the system. A good example are sea urchins on coral reefs. Fast-growing macroalgae live on coral reefs. They can overgrow and smother coral. Fortunately, sea urchins Grays on these algae, thus keeping the coral clean and healthy. Due to mass mortality of sea urchins, algae became dominant on many reefs in the Caribbean, covering the corals, making it impossible for them to catch light and filter water. Among the different ecosystems, various species can perform different keystone functions. Apart from keystone species for food web functions, we can also distinguish ecosystem engineers or eco-engineers. With this term, we are not referring to human engineers trying to use the building with nature technique. We are referring to plant or animal species that can change the abiotic environment in such a way that it affects the conditions for many other species. Mangroves and oysters are good examples of this. The roots of mangroves create nursing grounds for fish species and habitat for other crustaceans and many other animal species. Oysters filter the water and thereby have a large effect on water quality. Additionally, oyster reefs create structures that can reduce wave energy and alter sediment flow. You have learned that ecosystems evolve through succession. When creating a building with nature design, be specifically aware of the roles of pioneer species, keystone species, and ecosystem engineers, as they are the creators and maintainers of a healthy ecosystem.